Hello everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the setup of lists. So before I discuss the issue, I would like to show you the web page on the right hand side, and the code corresponding to this web page is shown on the left. So my HTML file simply has some headings, and after the first heading, I just have an unordered list. For my second heading, I would like to show you an ordered list with an ID called OL1. After that, I would have two more ordered lists to show you the ways to number the elements. Finally, I would have a description list that contains one description term and one description detail. So I would like to show you the ways to decorate these lists. So let us go to the first part, which is the unordered list. If we want to change the appearance of the unordered list, we can do something like this. So you can see that the entire unordered list element has its background color turned to light blue. So the element of the unordered list includes the bullet point and the list elements, which are shown inside the unordered list. We can also change the bullet point style. How can we do that? We can make use of an attribute. Okay, now you can see that the list style type has changed to hollow circle instead of the solid circle at the beginning. In addition to the circle type, we can try another type. Okay, when I use square as the value of the list style type attribute, I will see that the bullet point has changed to squares. Okay. So this is a simple way of changing the unordered list element entirely. If you want to change the appearance of the list elements inside an unordered list or even an ordered list, we can do something like this. So we first go to the selector indicated by the unordered list, followed by a space and a list element. And then we can type something like this. Okay, you can see that I just changed the list element to have a light green background. The bullet point color is not altered because the color for the bullet points are controlled by the entire UL element. Okay, so we can see the distinction between the list element inside an unordered list and the unordered list as a whole. Okay. After that, I would like to show you the ways to change the ordered list. In general, the styles that you can apply to an unordered list can also be applied to ordered list. Okay, I can also change the background color for the entire ordered list. Okay. Okay, this is one type of the list style type for an ordered list. An ordered list would have numbers to indicate the order of the lists. So we have some ways to set up the numbers. When I set decimal leading 0, I would like to simply give some zeros just before the numbers. Okay, so we can try other ways of the list style type for an ordered list. We can also choose lower Roman numbers as this style type, so we can see that the numbers have changed to the Roman numbers. Okay. Okay, the list style position is something that we need to discuss right now. You can see that the Roman numbers have been put inside the list element content. So this is quite different from the situation of the unordered list that I showed you previously. If I set the list style position as inside, we would have the numbers inside the list elements. So we have to notice that the default list style position is simply outside. So if you do not change the list style position, you will just have the numbers being put outside the list element. Also, I can set up the padding for my list elements. Now we can see that the padding has been given to the list elements so that they are a bit shifted to the right. So this is the portion of the padding. Okay. We can also set up the list element inside an ordered list a bit differently. So I can simply locate the list elements, which is shown by this selector. I first indicate the ID, and then I find out the list elements inside this ordered list element. So now you can see that the list elements have changed its background color to coral. So this is a way to set up the list element background color inside an ordered list. Now we go to the way to change the numbering of list items. So let me go to this ordered list. Now we see that the default way of setting the numbers is simply starting from 1, and then we increase the number by 1 for each of the upcoming list elements. Okay, so how can we change the numbering? We can do something like this as an example. If I say that the ordered list wants to start with 5, I can do something like this on the opening tag of the ordered list. I say start equals 5, and then you can see that the number would start with 5, and then the second element would be simply equal to 6, which is 1 larger than the first index. Okay, of course the third index would be 7, which is simply a value larger than the previous number by 1. Okay, if I say reversed as an additional keyword on the opening tag of the ordered list, we can see that the numbering has changed to 5, 4, and 3, so the order is reversed. Can we simply set up the numbers in an arbitrary manner instead of following this kind of strictly increasing or strictly decreasing trend? Yes, we have a way to do so. So let's go to the ordered list. Okay, I can simply set up my list element to start with a value of 5. So now the entire ordered list would have the numbers being 5, 6, and 7 for my 3 list elements. How about changing the value of the second list element? We can really do so. Now you can see that the second element has a value of 2. So I'm able to disrupt the order of the numbering by simply changing the value on the opening tag of my list element. So if the second element is having a number of 2, the third element will be simply having a number of 3, which is just one larger than the previous element. Okay, so if we don't disrupt the order, the remaining list elements would simply follow the increasing order, so that you will have a value of 1 larger than the previous element for each of your upcoming list elements. Finally, I would like to show you the ways to change the description list appearance. So let me go to this part. I have a description list, and inside this list I have a description term and a description detail. So I just focus on the description term first. So I can simply change the background color of my description term. And how about the description detail? We can simply use the way that applies to any other kind of ordered list or unordered list elements. Now I can change the font size of my description detail to 30 pixels. Now I'm also able to set up the padding of 60 pixels, so you can see that there is a larger space from the left-hand side than before. Okay, this is the space created from the padding. So we can see that there are so many ways to help us change the list appearance. And the idea can be applicable to any other kinds of list elements and list items. And the idea can be applicable to many other kinds of lists. For example, the order list, the unordered list, as well as a description list. We are also able to change the numbering of our list items by setting up the values on the HTML file directly. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.